Welcome, everybody. Welcome to the grand opening of the Phillips for Congress Ice Fishing Shack, our government repair shack.
It's gonna be great. It's gonna be great. I am excited.
I was in Wayzata High School yesterday and felt for the first time the anxiety that every student in this country faces every day when they go to school. And that is wrong, and the fact that neither party has taken steps, instant steps right now, to at least enhance the likelihood of preventing some of these tragedies is appalling to me.
What caused you to do this?
Well, you know me, I love conversation. I want to inspire people to come out and have a good time, and I want to run a campaign that's engaging and invitational and experiential. And the best way to get people to come out and have conversations is to offer something like this. So this is our government repair shack, our ice shack, for at least a month.
You're convinced the ice is safe?
And I'm convinced the ice is 29 inches. We drilled it, it's 29 inches thick. Yeah, well, you know, I've been issuing thoughts and prayers for 10 months after tragedy after tragedy. And I finally come to the conclusion that it's the responsibility of people like me to not just make it the news of the week, but to make this a substantial issue that needs to be considered and elevated. And I've called for some solutions, including universal background checks. I think it's time that we place mental health professionals in every public school in this country. I think we need anti-bullying programs in every school in this country. I think we need to afford the opportunity to the CDC to actually study this issue and come up with some solutions. I also think, most importantly, we got to address campaign finance reform, because the inactivity, if you will, in my estimation, is because of the money in politics. And we all know how strong the gun lobby is. And this is not about taking guns out of law-abiding citizens' hands. This is about preventing mass murders.
Should assault weapons be outlawed?
I think assault weapons should be outlawed. I think we should go back to the same ban that was in place during the Clinton era that I believe was successful. Mm-hmm. We already constitutionally preclude people from owning machine guns, from, you know, automatic weapons. This is the AR-15 that's caused so much destruction in such a short period of time. Is, I believe, something that we got to consider banning, along with the assault weapons, similar ones, yeah. Semi-automatics. Yes.
Position on the minimum wage.
Yeah. Well, the minimum wage. I want to see everybody do better. That's my principle. And at my own coffee shops, I pay.
I've heard that before.
Yeah, sure. I'm sure you have. And I pay a $15 minimum wage to every employee at Penny's, plus their tips. Not because we have to, and not because it's easy, because it's not, but it's the right principle. And I want to see everybody do better. And that means if you work hard, you shouldn't be living in poverty. And you know, I also recognize that we have to be thoughtful about how we do so. Because if we have an instantaneous move to $15 an hour, in my estimation, that will actually accelerate the move to automation in too many cases and actually reduce employment. Mm-hmm. And we have to recognize consequences of our policy decisions. So I want to find a thoughtful way to ensure that everybody who works hard does okay.
The other question is on health care.
Sure.
Because people are not quite clear where you stand.
Well, my position is very clear. I want to see health care for everybody in this country. I believe we should make the moral choice.
Single payers.
I believe their health care for all is... Single payer is a tactic. There are a lot of ways to get there, and I recognize the distinction. I want to see our country make the choice to afford care to everybody who needs it, when they need it, no matter their condition, their age, their income, or their geography. The question is how to achieve that. We have a Republican-controlled House of Representatives, Republican-controlled Senate, and White House. We have seen how hard it is even for Republican control to even get rid of the ACA. So we have to recognize the need to come up with a thoughtful policy that Democrats and Republicans can work towards. In my estimation, the best way to start that migration is expanding Medicare as an option for all, find thoughtful ways to expand Medicaid to cover those who cannot, to ensure that Medicare can negotiate prescription drug pricing to lower the cost of care, and to ensure that we look at our care delivery model, which right now rewards procedures and hospitalization, not prevention and quality.
What other issues have you had come up on the campaign trail?
The environment. You know, as we sit on a beautiful Saturday afternoon in winter on 29 inches of ice, there was a time not long ago we were wondering if we'd even have ice. And you know, climate change has got to be addressed. Incentives to invest in clean energy and renewables. Women's rights. The fact that the ERA is still not been ratified in this country is a significant concern of mine and something I wish to elevate. There's a lot to talk about. And as you know, your first question was about why this shack. It's to get people from all perspectives to come out and chat, recognize that we all want the same outcomes, and join together in trying to get it done. That's the change I want to bring to Washington. Eric Paulson does just the opposite. Hides behind television screens, doesn't have town halls, doesn't face the public unless it's a curated a very measured event. And I like the opposite. I think everybody should have a chance to speak with their representative, or in this case, potential representative. After the ice season, we're going to drive our shack all around the district and set up our campaign office in front of the people and bring the campaign to people instead of asking people to come to us.
Be part of the team.